गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू अंडरस्टैंड द पावर केस, पावर इन एसी सर्किट्स, इट्स डेरिवेशन वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड. सो द फॉर्मूला ऑफ पावर इन एनी एसी सर्किट दैट इज ईआरएमएस आईआरएमएस इनटू कॉस फाई, और इन फॉर्म ऑफ डॉट प्रोडक्ट ऑल्सो वी कैन राइट इट बिकॉज इट इज ए बी कॉस थीटा. सो ए बी कॉस थीटा इज ए डॉट बी, दैट्स वाई it is ERMS vector dot IRMS vector. Okay, now let us start the proof. The proof will be this way. The power we will solve for any general circuit. Okay, general circuit means out of the 6 AC circuits, voltage we already know that voltage supply is written E0 sin omega t, and current is obtained from the circuit and which comes different for different circuits. That means the phase angle phi may appear for different circuits. So like for the R circuit, the phase angle is 0. For C and L circuits, the phase angle is plus minus 90. So that we will apply according to the circuit. So just now we are solving the power derivation for general equations. Okay, so we will take a general phase angle phi which may appear for any AC circuit. Okay, let us start. Power formula, power is work upon time. So for the one complete cycle of AC, that means 0 to capital T, total work is integration of dW, so limit will be 0 to T. Now dW, that means the work done, in form of charge and voltage it can be written as dQ into V, okay, new charge into old voltage, this formula which we have already used in electrostatics. After that, dQ can be written as idt, okay, dQ is idt and V is extra upon t is going on. Now that means we have to use here the equations of any AC circuit. So now only we will substitute the value. Voltage is E0 sin omega t, current is I0 sin omega t plus phi into dt, okay. dt means integration with respect to time is going on. So limit will be 0 to capital T, and this denominator T is 1 by T written. Okay. Now the constants which we will be taking out are E0 and I0. So E0, I0 will come out of integration, and what is left? That is sine A and here sine B. Now we have to apply the mathematical technique to solve this integration. So sine A plus B is appearing here. Okay, sine A plus B formula is sine A cos B plus cos A sine B. This we will apply at this part. So let us start writing. It will become E0 I0 by T, 0 to T. This sine omega T will remain as it is. And here we are opening it with the help of this formula. So we need to put a bracket. So it will become sine A cos B plus cos A sine B, and dt is outside. Okay. Now we have multiplied this sine omega t inside. So sine omega t, it will become sine square omega t and cos phi here. So first part is this part. We have separated this integration. Then this sin omega t we have to multiply with this part, so sin omega t into cos omega t into sin phi dt. So this is the second integration. This term which is common, it is common for both sides of both the integrations. Okay, after this step, now you can see cos phi is not depending on time. Cos phi is that phase angle which is constant. Okay, it can be 30, it can be 90 degree, anything. So this cos phi is constant, it should be taken out of integration. Now inside the integration, sin square omega t will remain. If cos is taken out, then sin square will remain. But we don't solve the sin square theta directly in the integration because the square is there. So how to remove this square term? We have this formula. Sin square theta is equal to 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2. Okay, we need to use this formula. So wherever any mathematical formula I am using, that is written with the red pen. You can note it down separately in a paper. Now let us apply. sin square omega t we wanted to convert. So sin square theta formula. Okay. So 1 minus cos 2 theta. So 2 omega t. Okay. This 2 is multiple of omega t. It's not cos square. It is cos 2 theta. Okay. Cos 2 omega t by 2. So power has been removed. Okay. So sin square theta means 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2 dt. Dt is there. In this side of integration also you can see sin phi is constant. It will come out. Now sin omega t cos omega t both are appearing. So what we can do here, we can multiply and divide by 2 like this. So what will happen? 2 sin theta cos theta is sin 2 theta. Here the formula is written. 2 sin theta cos theta is sin 2 theta. So 2 sin omega t cos omega t will become sin 2 omega t. And this upon 2 will remain as it is dt. Okay. Till here we have solved this integration. That means we have properly converted it in form of integration, simple integrations. Now we have to solve it in the next sheet. Note down till this step. Our last step was this of the power. So what will happen? E0 I0 by T, it will remain out. Then here, this 2 is also a constant. It can be taken out. So cos phi upon 2 is taken out here. Then we have to do integration of only 1 minus cos 2 omega t. Okay, only 2 is taken out. In the same manner, here also, this 2 is constant, it can be taken out. So now, sin phi by 2 taken, sin 2 omega t is remaining inside the integration. Now we will need these integration formulas. 1 ka integration hota hai t. Okay, that means 1 dt is t only. Cos ka integration hota hai sin. Sin ka integration hota hai minus cos. Let us apply all these formulas here. So you can see now we have applied. This thing is constant out. Cos phi by 2 is out. Now once integration is t. Then cos integration is sin theta. But 2 omega is extra other than t. So 2 omega is divided in integration. Here sin phi by 2 is out. And sin's integration. Sin integration is minus cos theta. So minus sign will appear. And 2 omega is multiple extra, so it will be divided because integration we are doing. After that, you must be remembering that our limits are 0 to t. Limits are 0 to t. That means after doing integration, we have to apply the limits. So limit formula, upper limit minus lower limit. This we are going to apply. Limit application. On t, upper limit capital T, lower limit 0. So upper limit minus lower limit. Then this side minus 1 upon 2 omega is out because constant and sin 2 omega t is pe limit lagani hai. So ek bar t ki jage capital T aur ek bar t ki jage 0. Okay, so sin 2 omega capital T minus sin 0. Okay, 2 omega into 0 is completely 0. Okay, then here minus sin is taken out, 2 omega is also taken out. So sin phi upon 4 omega, now limit. Cos 2 omega capital T minus cos 2 omega 0. So it is cos 0. Now how to solve this omega T limit? Let us understand. See, omega is 2 pi by T. Okay, so what is omega T? It is 2 pi. Okay, so here also. Here omega capital T is appearing. Its meaning is 2 pi. So it is becoming 4 pi. And you should know that sin n pi is 0. Okay, sin n pi is 0. Then sin 0 is also 0. Then cos. If cos n pi comes, it is decided by even and odd. Okay, if it is even, then plus 1. If it is odd, then minus 1. And cos 0 is 1. Let us use all these values here. Okay. So let's see. Here sin 4 pi is appearing. Sin 4 pi is 0. sine 0 is also 0. Here cos 2 omega t. So omega t means 2 pi. Cos 2 omega t means cos 4 pi. 4 pi is even number. So its answer is 1. Then cos 0 is also 1. Okay. So this way we have substituted the limits. After getting the limit values, cos 5 by 2 t minus 0. Here 1 upon 2 omega. Its bracket is 0 minus 0. Here sin 5 by 4 omega. Its bracket is having 1 minus 1. So you can see this bracket is also 0. 1 minus 1 0. 0 into something is 0. Here also it is 0. Only what is remaining, that is E0 I0 by T 2 cos 5 by 2 into T. Okay, these things are remaining. E0 I0 by T cos 5 by 2 and T here. Achha, only 1, 2 is appearing. Okay, after that, you can see this T is getting cancelled. And the 2 which is alone here, we can divide it, we can distribute it in with E0 and I0 both by root 2 root 2. So we can write it this way, E0 and I0 both have root 2 denominator. And other than that, cos phi is extra. Now you already know that E0 by root 2 and I0 by root 2 means, E0 by root 2 means ERMS. And I0 by root 2 means IRMS. Root means square values. Okay. Into cos phi. So this way we have obtained our answer. Okay. So whenever the power of any circuit is asked, so the formula is ERMS, IRMS, cos phi. Or we can write it in the dot product also, because AB cos theta is A dot B. So this ERMS, IRMS, cos phi is E vector dot I vector. Okay, so this is the final answer. Now we can apply the power formula for different AC circuits. Let us continue. Note down this till this answer. This is the final answer of power. Now we will solve special cases. Let us see all the circuits. We have studied AC circuit, means AC supply connected to R only, AC supply connected to L only, AC supply connected to C capacitor only. So these were the basic circuits. Then we studied LR, CR and LCR circuit. Then we can also make a case of resonance LCR circuit. Now we need to calculate the power. Okay, at least the power idea we should have. So this phi will help us. For R circuit phi is 0. For L and C circuit the phi is plus minus 90. Okay. Now we will apply it in the power formula. Power is ERMS, IRMS, cos phi. Here phi is 0. Cos 0 is 1. That means maximum. That's why the power is also maximum. This cos phi term is called power factor. So that is 1. That means power is maximum. Okay. For L and C circuit, phi is 90. So if we apply cos minus 90 or cos plus 90, both are 0. So power is 0 in L and C circuit. Okay. Now you must have noticed that for LR, CR and LCR circuit, the phi values are not the constant values. That is that are not the fixed value like 90, 30. That are depending upon the XLR or XC. Okay. So for LR circuit, 10 phi formula we already know. Phase angle XL upon R. Okay. 10 phi we know. But for power, we have to put the cos phi. Okay, we have to put cos phi. So what we will do with the trigonometry, with the help of trigonometry. From 10 phi, we will first solve cos phi. Then we will put in power. 10 phi is XL upon R. So 10 formula is what? Perpendicular upon base. So we already know perpendicular and base. Now we will make it from this cos phi. Cos phi is what? Base upon hypotenuse. Okay, base upon hypotenuse. Base is R. Okay, base is R. Now hypotenuse how to get? Root of perpendicular square plus base square. So root of perpendicular square and base square. So XL square plus R square. This way we will obtain the cos phi formula. This also you can say that it is R by Z. Impedance. Right? R by impedance. ओके सो कॉस 5 बना लिया, उसके बाद इसको पावर में रखना है. पावर इज ERMS IRMS इंटू कॉस 5. कॉस 5 की जगह रखा R बाय रूट ऑफ XL स्क्वायर प्लस R स्क्वायर दिस टर्म. ओके इन द सेम मैनर वी कैन सॉल्व द अदर सर्किट्स ऑल्सो. ओके 10 5 से कॉस 5 सॉल्व किया और कॉस 5 को पावर में पुट किया. CR सर्किट ऑल्सो लाइक दिस ओनली 10 5 cos 5 पुट cos 5 इन पावर फॉर्मूला. सो हियर इट वॉज XL स्क्वायर, नाउ हियर इट इज XC स्क्वायर. एंड इफ इट इज LCR सर्किट 10 5 फॉर्मूला इज दिस. सो cos 5 वी विल ऑप्टेन. सो पावर फॉर्मूला विल बी ERMS IRMS cos 5. सो R इज एवरीवेयर इन द न्यूमरेटर. द रूट इज द डिनोमिनेटर इज चेंजिंग. रूट ऑफ R स्क्वायर प्लस XL माइनस XC होल स्क्वायर नाउ. ओके दिस वे यू हैव टू मेक द पावर फॉर्मूलाज इफ इन द एग्जाम फॉर डिफरेंट सर्किट्स द पावर इज आस्क्ड. ओके लास्ट केस इज अ स्पेशल केस रेजोनेंस LCR सर्किट. फॉर रेजोनेंस मीन्स व्हेन दिस LCR सर्किट इज अंडर द कंडीशन ऑफ रेजोनेंस देन वी नो दैट XL एंड XC आर सेम फॉर रेजोनेंस. सो 10 5 इज 0 दैट्स व्हाई 5 इज 0. ओके नाउ पावर फॉर्मूला ERMS IRMS cos 5. 5 is 0 just now, so cos 0 is 1, that means power is maximum. So it's like R case only. Whenever 5 is 0, the power is maximum. So in LCR circuit also, one such condition is there when power is maximum, that is resonance condition. Okay, so this way we solve the power of different circuits. An extra formula you can remember, power factor. Okay, power फॉर्मूला तो होता है ERMS IRMS cos 5. इसमें से जो cos 5 टर्म है उसको हम पावर फैक्टर बोलते हैं. ओके cos 5 का फॉर्मूला जब भी सॉल्व करोगे किसी भी सर्किट के लिए इट विल कम R बाय Z. ओके सो R बाय Z इज द फॉर्मूला फॉर पावर फैक्टर. ओके सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द पावर.